In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
You are all welcome to this wonderful celebration, the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We know the role of Mary. She is very, very special. She is the co-redeemer. She is the mediatrix of all graces. And now she is assumed into heaven, body and soul. Almighty ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the ark of his covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed in the sun with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its head were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in the heavens say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Takes her place at your right hand in gold of Ophir. Hear, O daughter, and see, turn your ear, forget your people and your father's house. So shall the king desire your beauty, for he is your Lord. They are born in with gladness and joy. They enter the palace of the king. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
those who live by technology will die by technology. So I had a great idea. I prepared my brief homily and sent it to the printer. Nothing. But I sent it to another printer. Nothing. But here's my trusty little iPad. I have a little secret to share with you. Well, maybe it's not a secret to you, but it was kind of to me, about this feast, the Assumption of Blessed Virgin Mary into the glory of heaven. I've not always fully appreciated what we're celebrating here. My focus always seemed to fall on what happened to Jesus' mother. And I think it's worth noting that what we celebrate here is not something that Mary did, but something that she received. The idea is that in some true, real way, the mother of the Savior was herself saved from the corruption that is death, a process of disintegration, the separation of the soul from the body. Now, whether Mary died and was carried to the state of perfect peace and hope that we call heaven, or just did not die exactly, but was carried into the heavenly state to live eternally, this is not defined in the words of Pope, now Venerable Pius XII. But that Mary is living beyond death with her Son, Jesus, and the Father in the communion of the Holy Spirit, that's what we celebrate. But that's not all. What interests me more than that is that in providing to Mary this wondrous benefit, our saving Lord shows us what is God's desire and design for each one of us. And for the church. This last piece of information, that we are not alone in our being called to heavenly glory, is easy to miss because we so easily think of ourselves as if God's love for me was something private, just individual. Closer to the truth is that God loves you perfectly for who you are. Absolutely. And that God loves you for the benefit of the people around you. The gifts you have received from God, talent and insight and sense of humor and energy and goodwill, these gifts are given you to share with us, the rest of us. This celebration, this Mass, this acknowledgement of God's generous kindness to Mary, we should recognize is a gift to us. The assurance that Mary is not the only recipient of this grace, but only the first of us whose destiny is to be whole and complete, human and divine when the work of Christ is complete. The secret is that we must graciously accept this gift to Mary as the promise of our own blessed life in God. But here are a couple of questions. How is it that Mary was chosen to receive the gift? How is it that the divine providence prepared her to receive this gift? And how is God preparing us, each of us, and all of us together for the same gift? What is God doing for you now to prepare you for heaven?